Hey guys, in this video I want to go over kind of a beginner video on Python for data science, and in particular I want to go over how you can import a text file that has a data set into Python. So it's basically going to be how you can import data into a Python script. And in particular, in this video, we're going to use a Python library called pandas, which is basically the most common Python library that you use in order to import data into Python. So since pandas is a Python library, you have to have it installed on your local version of Python. So in my case, I already do have that Python library installed already, but if you don't, you want to open up a terminal window and run pip install pandas. If I run that, I already have it installed, so it's not really going to do anything. It's just going to say requirement already satisfied. But basically for my computer setup, I'm running Python 3.8 and I already have pandas, the Python library, installed. So we're going to use that Python library to import text files or .csv files into Python. And I have this Python script open in VS Code. This is just a short script that has two different examples for how you can import data. So let's go ahead and go over this script. For importing data, I'm going to assume that you have some .csv file or .txt file or .dat file on your computer that you want to import. You can also import a URL, and I'll get to that in the second example. But for running a Python script, you basically always want to create a directory for your Python script. And so I, on my local computer, have a folder called import underscore data. And this directory has the Python script that I'm running and the text file that I want to import. This is the dataset. And as you can see, it's a dataset with a bunch of rows and a couple different data types and different columns. And it's housing prices in London. This was just a random data set that I found on Kaggle. I downloaded that and I have it in the same folder as my Python script, my importdata.py. And so now let's actually go into the Python script and see how we can import the data. The first thing we're going to want to do, since we want to use the pandas library, is we want to import the pandas library. So the first thing you want to do at the top of your Python script is run the line import pandas, and optionally you can set it as pd. So this is basically just loading in that Python library. And then that lets me run functions from the Python library pandas. And when I call those functions, I'm going to call them pd dot and then give the name of the function that I want to call. The function in pandas that reads text files or .csv files or .dat files, which are basically the most common text files that have data in them, is read underscore csv. So when you want to import your data, you're going to set some variable name. So I'm calling it London underscore data. That's going to be the variable that holds my data frame. And I'm going to set that variable equal to pd dot read underscore csv. So this is going to be the function that reads in a CSV file. And then the only parameter that it needs is the path to the file. So if you run it on your computer, you're going to want to pass in quotation marks, the path to the file that you want Python to read in. In this example script, instead of passing in directly the name of the string, I pass in a variable, but the variable I set to be equal to the string that has the path file. So it's the same thing. I could have just put this string directly into the parentheses, but instead, to make the code a little bit cleaner, I just created a variable path to file, and that has the string with the full path, and then I pass into read underscore CSV the variable name of the string. So I'm going to go ahead and run those two lines of code. So I have set the variable path underscore to file to be equal to the path file, and I'm going to load that in to read underscore CSV. Now in Python, when you import data, depending on what IDE you're using, it doesn't really show a lot of changes to the output just by loading in the data. So you might not see that something has happened, but there are ways of checking that you loaded in your data set correctly. You can do that by checking what's in your London underscore data variable. So for example, in this line of code, I say to print the head of the London underscore data variable. If I run this line of code, then it will print to the terminal the first 5 lines of the dataset. When I look at the output on the terminal of the head, it looks like the dataset was loaded incorrectly. So if I go back to the data that we're loading in, on this file, the .csv file, the first row of the data is actually the column names, which is very common in a lot of datasets. If you don't pass in any optional parameters to read underscore CSV, the default is it's going to read the first row as the column names. And so that did it correctly for this file because the first row is column names. Then if you wanted to get, for example, the shape of the data set, so if you wanted to know how many rows of data do we have and how many columns are in the data set, you could do the variable name of your data frame, so London underscore data dot shape. And then I'm going to print that to the terminal window. And when I run that, it outputs the shape of the data set that we imported. This data set had 13,549 rows and 7 columns. And then I'm also going to just print to the screen the different data types that are the columns of our data frame. So that's going to be print London underscore data dot D types, which stands for data types. And then this prints to the screen what are considered the different data types of each column. So there's a date column, and that's considered an object. There's an area column. There's code, houses sold, that's a float, number of crimes, etc. That gives me the data types for the 7 different columns. Okay, so if you check that with your data set, you can see that it should have been loaded incorrectly. So that's one example of loading in or importing data in Python. The second example I'm going to do is just similar with a different data set. And so this is going to be an example of loading in data from a URL. So you can also do that in Python. So the same thing as last time, instead of passing in the path or the URL directly into read underscore CSV, I just save it as a variable name beforehand. And to import data into Python from a URL, it's basically the same thing. So in quotation marks, you're creating a string, and that string has the complete URL to your data set. And this was just another data set that I found online. So this is resid underscore energy dot dat. And so this would be the full URL that I copy into my quotation marks. And this data set is a little bit different from the other one. So the first row in this data set does not have any column names. And also this is not a CSV file. It's a dot dat file. And the columns of data in this data set are no longer separated by commas. So that's the default separator for the different columns in read underscore CSV, because CSV is a comma separated value file. So read underscore CSV can read from text files and it can read from dot dot files like this example, but you're going to have to add an additional parameter that tells it when to separate into different columns. So in this case, I'm going to do an example of using spaces as the separator for the different columns. So to do that, I'm going to again call read underscore CSV. I'm going to pass in the name of the URL as a string. Then the next optional parameter that I have to define in this case is going to be the separator. So the separator is a parameter, and this one tells you what separates the cells into different columns. And we said that we want to have spaces. So to have spaces, it's going to be R and then in quotation marks backslash S plus. And so this line of code basically says that if there is one or more space, set that into the next column. So use that as the separator. And additionally, we have to add another optional parameter, which is header, because for this particular data set, the first row does not have column names. So we have to let Python know that we do not have any column information. So to do that, you put header is equal to none with capital N. And so that's a special command that says the first row in the data set that you're importing is actually the first row of the data. So there's no header information, which is assumed if you don't add any parameters besides the path to file. So I'm going to run these two lines of code to import my data set. And then the same thing, just to check that we imported the data correctly, I'm going to print out some descriptive statistics about the data set. So I'm going to print the head, which gives me the first 5 rows of the data set. And I can compare that to the URL that has the data. So the first line should be 1984, 235.83. So that's correct. And then I'm going to load in this shape. So it's 27 rows and 9 columns. And then I can also see the information about the data types. In this case, we did not name any of the 9 rows. So it just names them 0 through 8. And only the first one was an integer. And that's correct because the first column was just the year and all the other values are floats. So by checking that, we see that we have correctly imported the data using pandas and using read_CSV. If you want more information about optional parameters, you can always check the function information. pandas.read_CSV has more optional parameters and different values that you can pass into those parameters. And panda also has other functions for reading in other data as well. So I went over read_CSV. It also has other options. For example, if you want to read in an Excel file, you would do pd.read_Excel, and then you could pass in through a string the path file to an Excel sheet, for example. So that's a very common way of importing data into Python, and that's it for this video.